Okay, let's get this shit started. So I just watched the new Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie, and that shit fucking sucked. Like, that shit was so bad. So this one, it takes place 50 years after the first one, which is something they already tried with, I think it was like 2012, they had Texas Chainsaw 3D with fucking Alexandria Daddario. Trey Songz was in that bitch. Like, at the end of the first one, you know, everyone's like, you know, it's over and done with. But the town comes back and they try to grab a baby. And it's the 70s, right? Like, you assume the first movie comes out in the 70s, so this one's in the 70s. So they grab the baby. It says 20 years later, the baby turns out to be Alexandria Daddario. Like, okay, that makes no sense. So it'd be in the 90s, right? But you got people using freaking smartphones. You got modern cars. Like, what the hell is this? Like, this doesn't match up. So whatever. It's not about that movie. It's about this movie. Something they already tried before and failed at miserably. So let's see how they do it a second time. You got the main characters. There's four characters. There's the curly-headed clown lady. There's the Instagrammer, Dante, who the whole time I was just imagining being I'm Dante, the YouTuber. And then you got the emo girl. You can tell she's the main character. It's like, okay. And then you got Dante's girlfriend. I looked it up. Her name was like Ruth or something, but the Netflix subtitles just said Dante's girlfriend. So I'm just gonna refer to her as that. Not like she's in the movie that long. The way they set this one up is the characters buy like the town the Texas Chainsaw Murders happened in. I think maybe it's nearby, but they buy like this whole ass empty town and they're gonna like do whatever the fuck, you don't know. Well, on the way, they're driving there, on the way, they see this fucking redneck guy, you know, big old diesel truck, shooting fumes out, blasting death metal, and he's got, like, his gun license or whatever. He's showing that shit around, letting everyone know, and they joke about it. He's like, oh, fuck you, just an asshole. They get to their spot, they realize the redneck guy is the mechanic. Ooh, what a twist. And they see a house repping that fucking Confederate flag out there. So Dante is like, all right, I'm gonna go in there, get rid of that shit. He's trying to get rid of it. But oh, they thought the whole place was empty. There's still someone there. This is old ass lady here. There's an old ass lady there. So she's like fighting, howling, saying, I still own this land. And then she just has a fucking heart attack. Like, she's just dead. So the fucking ambulance pulls up, and for some reason, the curly-headed clown is like, I need to go with her. I need to go with her to the hospital. Now. Like, why? Like, you don't know her. You didn't kill her. She had a heart attack. I mean, maybe that's your fault, but like, why do you need to go? Like, they're talking about how they got all these people here. Because they're like showing off the town, so they got all these people coming in. It's like, okay, why the fuck do you need to go? Like, who cares? She got her big ass son, which is Leatherface, carrying her out. It's like, she's good. She don't need nobody. But nah, Dante's girlfriend is like, I'm gonna go with. Just, I guess, to shut her up. But why? Why does she need to go? So you already know she's fucking dead. It's literally just an excuse to kill someone. So then the emo girl starts hanging out with the redneck guy. And he's like showing around his guns. And then she gets a flashback. And I guess she's like a mass shooting survivor. So she's got like PTSD with guns. but she's just chilling out with the redneck guy, and her sister comes in there and she's freaking the fuck out. Like, okay. Then the girlfriend dies. Not a surprise. We all expected that. There's this fucking lame ass jump scare though, where he like pops into the window really fast. Leatherface is so funny. So the redneck gets word that the old lady died. So then he just takes everyone's keys for some reason. So I guess, yeah, they murdered her because she had a heart attack. Like, it's not their fault. She's fucking 90 years old. Like, get her the fuck out of here. Get her in a fucking nursery home. Like, not there. So, by that time, the group coming to see the whole fucking town shows up. They're there to get lit, turn up, all that. There's something about Dante doesn't have, like, the papers to the house. So, the curly girl, whatever the fuck her name is, she's like, we gotta go check out the house. We gotta go check out the house. Make sure she has papers. It turns out she actually owned the house and they kicked her out for no reason, but you could have figured that out. Leatherface is there. He's going brazy. Fucking slashes up Dante's face. Dante runs out there. Then the redneck sees this shit. And this is so, I don't understand this movie. Now the redneck guy's like really cool. Even though they set it up at first, like he's an asshole. Like he's got the nasty truck. He's being a dick. Grabs a Confederate flag, but he looks pissed off about it. Like he didn't want to grab it. And now he's supposed to be the hero. Like he grabs his guns. And he runs in there and he's like all like badass and shit. Like they play this epic music. And I was just so confused. I'm like, aren't I supposed to not like this guy? Like there's definitely some undertones of gun control. So it's like, is it pro gun control, anti gun control? Cause there's a school shooter girl and there's a redneck. And I guess like by the end of the movie, we're jumping ahead a little bit, but I guess by the end of the movie, the point is, guns are good. I don't know, Leatherface didn't fucking stay dead. So the redneck's in there, he gets fucked, but he was able to drop the keys out while the curly head clown is laying under the bed. So she grabs keys, runs out. It conveniently starts to rain outside while that shit's going on. So all the crowd there get back into like the tour bus. They're still getting lit, you know? And then Leatherface is coming back on his way from butchering Dante and the redneck. He's on his way. And this is by far probably the best scene in the movie. I mean, it's at least the best kill. I wouldn't say it's the best scene. But Leatherface gets in there. He's like, starts trying to kill everyone. He's like, he's going after everyone. And then everyone's just like, pulls out their phone at the same time. Starts recording on Instagram Live, and I was just sat there in awe. Like, really? This is what you're gonna fucking do? And they're like, oh, I got Instagram meth. And then Leatherface just fucking saws the dude in half. Which is pretty cool, I guess, but it's just, oh, you know, social media bad. I'm like, I don't need that in my Texas Chainsaw movie. So then the coolest kill is like the one lady is like getting out, trying to get out of the bus. Leatherface just comes up and now she's crawling out the window. He just saws her in half. And that shit was pretty cool. And then she just falls down and you see like her guts all over the windowsill. That was really cool. That was the only props I'll give this movie though, is that one kill was cool. And the lighting was kind of cool in that scene. I'm just a sucker for neon shit though, like anything neon. Sally Hardesty's in this movie. She was a lady from the first one. And they're trying to do, I forgot to mention that, they like set her up. Like a little few teaser scenes, but who fucking cares? And they try to do the same thing Halloween 2018 did. But it's not the same. Like, Sally was a cool, she did her job for the first movie. Like, she got her job done in the first movie, but she wasn't like Jamie Lee Curtis in Halloween. We're like, I need to see her. Like, she's cool. She's in a bunch of the movies. Well, she's in what? Jamie Lee Curtis in like what? She's only in the first two. But still, you know, she's more memorable. Like Jamie Lee's more, it makes more sense. You see her in more of the movies. Texas Chainsaw, you see Sally, and then they just, oh, she's this badass now. Like she's exactly like Halloween 2018. And I'm like, really? Like you're really trying to do this shit? So she pulls up to that bitch, loaded up. She finds Leatherface somehow, I don't remember. But she just has a gun pointing at him. She's pointing at him the whole time. She's like, this, you remember, blah, 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 blah. She names off all the characters from the first one. And he's just sitting there, not saying anything. I'm like, bitch, pull the trigger. He's right there, pull the fucking trigger. Like, he doesn't care.
Bruh.
Just so stupid. I hate when movies do that. Like, I get it. Oh, she's in shock. She's finally seeing Leatherface again. But just blew his fucking brains out and look at him after that. Like, goddamn. She's fucking starts going after Leatherface again. And then Leatherface just comes up and shows his chainsaw right up her belly. She gets fucked up. So she's laying in the dump. So she there's her 5 minutes in the movie. It's like, what's the point of that? At least in Halloween 2018, Jamie Lee Curtis is like, she's not the main character, but she is one of the main characters. Like, she's important to the movie. You could take Sally out. And really, the movie wouldn't change. Like, you could write around it. Like, at the end of the movie, you really don't need Sally. So I just don't get it. It's just trying to write off the coattails of Halloween 2018. Sally locks them in the car, the two girls that are left, the curly head clown and the emo girl. She locks them in the car for some reason, but she throws them the keys and she's like, get out of there. This was before she died, or died. So they're driving the car, they're whipping the car, and they hit Leatherface, barely, they like fucking grazed them. And then they just crash, because of course, why wouldn't they? They crash, and then Leatherface is like doing something, and then, oh, Sally's not dead. She's still alive, and she shoots him a few times. Then he runs into the, like, a movie theater or something. And she tells the school shooter girl, she's like, you can't run, or he'll haunt you for your life. So she runs in there, and of course, is a stupid-ass jump scare. But there is a scene where Leatherface, like, fucking chucks his chainsaw, like, 50 feet. It's so awesome, like, it's laughably bad. So yeah, she's trying to kill Leatherface, then the fucking curly head girl comes in, saves the day, they both kill him. He falls into like just some random hole in the ground that is full of water in the movie theater. Hey, fuck if I know, man. So he's obviously dead. He's been shot like 10 times, he's been drowned. So it's all good. The movie wraps up. They're all joking. All their friends are dead. Everyone's fucking dead. But, you know, Melanie and the emo girl are joking. So they get into their off-brand Tesla. They set up the maps. You know, they get out that bitch. Car just starts taking off by itself. And then, Leatherface just grabs the curly girl. Drags her out of the fucking car. Like, Nightmare on Elm Street style. And then the emo girl like gets she's like poking her head out the car just screaming while the car is driving itself, and it's supposed to be like a reference to the ending of the first one, but it's so bad. Like I'm like, I just want to see that the last shot, but like from far away, where it's just a self-driving car and she's like sticking her head out and she's like, ah, like it's so bad. It's so bad. Like my friend came over and I had to show him that last scene just so he knew how fucking terrible this movie was.
Let's go home.
Autopilot engaged.
Fuck Carla. Hey, you know what? I changed my mind actually. I'll move here with you.
Fuck off.
So there was something else I forgot to add, which is the fact that Leatherface is not fucking invincible. Like, maybe if you count the sequels, Leatherface could be like Jason or some shit, where he's taking shots, he's taking fucking hits everywhere. But nah, if you're continuing from the original one, Leatherface is a normal fucking dude. He's just a regular, I wouldn't say regular, but he's supposed to be a normal person, you know, maybe a little stronger than other people, but he can't take 7 fucking shotgun blasts to the head and survive. Just ridiculous. This whole movie is ridiculous. Like, if you're gonna continue from the first one, follow the rules of the first one. Simple, isn't it? I can make a better Texas Chainsaw movie. Are you hearing this? You hearing it? What is it? Lionsgate? Is it Lionsgate? Whoever the fuck. Ask me. I'll make you a fucking fantastic Texas Chainsaw movie. Hit me up. So now for my final thoughts on the movie. It's fucking terrible. I'm sure you knew that from this video. It's everything about it is bad. Like, the acting's bad, characters bad, story bad. Some of the kills are okay, but they're just generic as fuck. Like, the reason the first one works is because you don't see the kills. It's like all implied. That first one is fucking terrifying. Like, that shit was still freaking out. And this one is it's not it. There's a weird Shining reference. Like, someone has a sledgehammer. I think it's Leatherface. Someone has a sledgehammer. And they're banging against the wall. It's doing the same way Kubrick did it in The Shining, the way the camera moves when Jack got to X. And I'm like, why is it referencing this? Like, it's a cool shot, undoubtedly. But the Kubrick one, not this one. Like, this one's just like, why? Why would you, what is the need to reference that? There's no correlation at all. I don't get that. A lot of the references are just that normal fan shit. I just watched Free Guy. My brain's dead from that. And it's like Free Guy tier references. Like, oh my God. Oh my God. It's a reference to the first movie. Why don't you reference fucking Matthew McConaughey? Bring him back for the next sequel. Please bring back some fucking Matthew McConaughey. He was so good in that one.
Don't hurt her.
Give her a kiss.
Now, how could I hurt a pretty face like this?
But then, I am in the mood for love.
So yeah, all in all, just a dog shit movie. Like, I guess if you're like with a bunch of friends, need something to do, you know, you down a couple beers, brewskis, shots, it'd be a really good fucking movie. But other than that, this is just garbage. Don't watch this, even if you have a Netflix subscription. Just stay away from it. There's no point. There's nothing you will get out of this movie. I've already forgotten everything. So that's all for this one. You know, trying something new. Face cam. This editing's hard. You know, I got a new song out called Missed Calls. A new Here and After. Fire. Check it out. You know, always dropping heat. Always dropping. So yeah, thanks for watching. Don't watch this movie, watch this video. And as always, have a nice day. Now they hit me up and I say that I'm on my other shit.